Hello, everybody, and welcome to episode 73 of Unknown Empire SMP. We are starting off my second year by adding things onto Polarctica, and as you can see, Unknown Empire has gotten a logo to go with the server. So, I've already recorded this episode once, but my recording software likes to mess with the microphone input every now and then, so my voice was not recorded during the entire thing. But luckily it wasn't anything super long, but, you know, these guys are still here. They still don't have names. I don't know what to call them. Maybe we'll have to come up with something for this guy, too. But this episode is all about additions to Polarctica, and you may be able to see some of them from here. So, the first thing is that we have a new polar bear right here, Morris, because while I was recording the last episode, I found him, like, standing right here, because polar bears are spawning all over the place now, especially in the fishing district, which is what I'm now calling this old part right here, with the cobblestone. Hello, Kento. And I'm just... I do not have the motivation, energy, or patience to replace all of the cobblestone with anything else, so I think I'm just gonna leave it the way it is, because it's kind of like the run-down, old-fashioned part of Polarctica, you know, with the Frosty Lodge. I mean, nobody ever goes over here, but yeah, as you can see, there's a polar bear right there. But yeah, I also fixed up the arches here. They all have two banners and lanterns now, and they've got more signs, so, you know, Polarctic Plaza is this main part right here, and the fishing district is what's over there. And as you can see, I've updated the map to show all of the changes and everything. But before we get on to the main part of this episode, which is over there, I wanted to show you something down here real quick, just a slight addition to the smeltery. So, just past Major Malevolence here, you know, he's still the man in charge. We have this guy over here. I call him Bruce, and he's our new armor smelter guy, and he's upgraded to master status, just like all the rest of the villagers in Polarctica. So, he's got some pretty good trades, actually, as well. for me, at least, I got these really good discounts on some pretty good stuff. And he also sells bells, which I've bought a few of, and him and Jack, which is the blacksmith for Polarctica, are the only villagers in Esten that I know of that actually sell the bells, but yeah, he's just going to be roaming around down here. Do not get stuck on the ladder. That's what happened to the snowman that was down here. But yeah, he's already been getting to work, you know, making some armor for us, in case we need to outfit our soldiers again. So yeah, you know, that's what we have done in the smeltery. I also went ahead and added Apoloth, this big cloud mass right above Tatros here, to the big map of Esten. So now I think I have every relevant location on there, at least. I don't know if I'm missing anything. What do you think, Pumpig? I think we're good. But yeah, Apoloth is Medical's place, so it's technically a Skull territory, I guess. So, I think that's it for all of the smaller scale stuff I've done. We still got our shoppers over here. We still have our polar bears and everything. But this part over here is the main event. So, we brought back Frosty the Greeter, amongst other things. And he's fully protected now because he used to get into some trouble and die a lot. But now he's safe and sound. He still says hello to everybody, but he doesn't... You know, he's not allowed to throw snowballs anymore. He's lost that privilege. In addition to the fishing district over there, we also have the Waffle district. The Waffle House just has its own district, because why not? So, yeah, you know, you just come in. This part, which is way more open now, you can just come in here if you want to shop or sightsee, or if you're hungry, you can get some waffles. So, through here we have a mini lake, so I guess you could fish here if you want, but we also have this archway, which is like another sort of main entrance to the city, I guess, and we also still have Sparky over here. He's chilling in his little pool. But right here is Polarctica Waffles, and this took me quite a while to build, actually, And if you come in here, it's actually a secret underground Waffle House, because Santa's workshop, which was built in the build event as part of the public district, is right on the other side of this wall, so I could not make it surface level. But yeah, I decided to build the whole thing off camera, because I don't like to build things on camera. I feel too rushed, and I just like to focus on the details, get the task done, because I don't really like to build either, but I like it when things are built, if that makes any sense. So yeah, I just like to show the final product nowadays. But I'm going to come down here, and as you can see, we have some honeycomb, or waffle blocks, and here we go. Here's the Waffle House, and I know there's not too many places to sit, but it's good enough, you know? We have honeycomb, or waffle blocks, right here. And in this chest right here, we have all the waffles, as you can see. Waffles upon waffles upon waffles. And we also have some syrup, I guess, yellow syrup, I don't know. Do people put honey on waffles? I don't know if that's a thing. But if it is, then we can just call it honey. You know, it's kind of like Banditos Burritos, you know, it's not completely authentic waffles, but it'll do. And right back here, we have the employees-only chamber of the Waffle House. And I know it's employees-only, but, you know, this is an exclusive tour, so I'm going to show you guys what's back here. So, okay. So, right through this door, we have the kitchen and our chefs. The bees. Yes, the bees make our waffles. It's definitely not honey. It's 100% waffles, just like Jeff's burritos are not potatoes. But basically what happens back here is that because I have these campfires right here, I'm able to just simply harvest the waffles from the beehives, because these guys were nice enough to help me out with that. And there are about, I don't know, 19 bees here? So there's always going to be a few out of the hives, because I think only 12 can be inside at a time. So yeah, I just spawned in a few more, and we got this baby bee right here. And this is a much better bee farm than the one in the Lost Kingdom, because these guys are all kind of trapped underground, so they can't escape, and all the hives are in one place, and it's just way better. So yeah, this is probably going to be the primary honey/waffle farm from now on, but you know, I do have spare ones just in case. But yeah, I really like this place. I used more than one type of wood, and I used these stripped logs, which I haven't used for quite some time. The Polarctic restaurant actually has a floor like this. I really like this build, and it took like a really long time, because I know it doesn't look like it, but it did, just because I had to get all of the waffles for the walls, because it was originally going to be ice, but I decided, you know, this looks a lot better. I mean, I think we can all agree, this blends in with the wood much better. This is like an exclusive people's only Waffle House, so, you know, that it's underground, it's for the elite members of Polarctic Society. I think that is it. I think I've shown you everything that needs to be shown today. I'm just gonna chill here in the hot tub with Barry. Although I don't really know if I'm chilling. I mean, it's a hot tub, but it's made of ice. So, I don't know. Barry, what do you think? He seems to be perfectly lukewarm. That is all of the additions we have for Polarctica. Stop pushing me, Squidward. That is it for this episode. I hope you all enjoyed, and I will see you in the next one. Goodbye!